Once again, jazz fans, you get to witness history courtesy of this wonderful individual. Heads up to the super screen for a John Stockton video.
The Utah Jazz select John Stockton of Gonzaga University.
The journey began in 1984 when the Utah Jazz selected a little-known point guard from Gonzaga University.
I'd like to say that I'm very excited at the possibility of playing with the Utah Jazz.
Few, if any, gave this bright-eyed young rookie a chance to last more than a year. But what they failed to measure was John Stockton's courage, determination, and his fierce will to win.
Streak off of here and go down the side. They do. Stock's got it. He's got running room. Stockton, dive, hang it up. It's good. It's good. The Jazz win it. The Jazz win it. I can't believe it. The Jazz win it.
Night in and night out, John gave his best. Win or lose, his resolve never wavered. And it wasn't long before NBA fans would stand up and take notice.
7 seconds, 6, 5, Stockton drives, put it up, it's good, Stockton, John Stockton, unbelievable.
There were times when he made the impossible look easy.
Look at that,
that's finished,
John Stockton. He just put his signature on this game.
NBA records would soon follow.
Shot up, it's it, he did it, he did it. A new NBA assist king.
And though he is small in stature, Stockton's accomplishments place him amongst the giants of the game.
I've said it many a time, I'll say it again. He's the greatest point guard that ever played a game.
John Stockton was a hero on the basketball court and a regular guy off of it. And maybe that's what made him so special. John was just one of us.
All you can do is prepare your best and lay it all out there. There's I'm sure people that have won championships that haven't had to work very hard at it. We've worked very hard and haven't done it, and yet I feel a lot of reward out of the effort. A lot of this is about the journey.
Well, the journey is over, and time has given us a perspective of 19 incredible seasons. Tonight, we get our chance to say thanks for letting us enjoy the ride.
Russell will inbound at half court.
Uh-oh.
Stockton, open three.
John Stockton, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, the greatest point guard in history. It's up there, all-time steals leader, 3,265, all-time assist leader, 15,806. Not at all, and he found time to score 19,711 points. And to honor him tonight with the unveiling going up of his uniform, his number 12, we're going to bring out first his old coach, Frank Layden.
Thank you, John. Congratulations to you and your family. Thank you for filling up this building. Thank you for building this building. Thank you for those championship flags. Every one of them, you had something to do with. We hope that your future is very bright, and we hope that God blesses you. And we can't say enough, but let's hope that someday you come back here to us.
Frank Layden, thank you. And now we bring up the owner of the Utah Jazz, Larry H. Miller.
Well, I've been thinking for weeks about what I'd say tonight. And there's really only one thing. On behalf of the fans, behalf of the franchise, behalf of my on behalf of my family and myself, thank you, and we love you.
New Jersey. Look it out. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the presentation of the Jazz original jersey in Salt Lake and the one that John played in his last few years. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we'll have the unveiling of the number 12 from up above. And John, I think we're going to bring the cord right down here, and maybe you can grab your kids and get them all in there. Okay, John, first of all, I'm sorry. Take the mic and thank these people, as only you can do.
Thank you. Thank you. We had a small gathering of family and friends last night, and we got together, and I just wanted to thank them for their impact on my life. And I want to include you with that, because when number 12 goes up here in a few minutes, I want you all to take pride in it, because you all had something to do with it. You came every night. You cheered for us every night, and I know I felt welcome every day I played out here. This is home. And so did my family. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's meet some of John's teammates here. We got a little time. How about Adrian Dantley out of Notre Dame? Jeff Hornacek, Horny. Thurl, Big T Bailey. The big fella, Mark Eaton. Second leading scorer in the history of basketball, Stockton to Malone. Now what you have been waiting for, on a countdown from Dan Roberts, our PA announcer, counting down from five.
Here we go, everybody. Let's count it down from five. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let her rip.
You're simply the best. Stop down.
greatest point guard in history. Thank you for coming tonight. Let's get on with basketball. And thank you for being here tonight.
Buddy, you're a boy. Make a big noise. Playing in the street. Gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face. You big disgrace. Kicking your can all over the place. Singing,
we will rock you.
A big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place.
We will rock you.
Sing it out.
We will rock you.
Buddy, you're an old man, poor man, pleading with your eyes. Gonna make you zombie someday. You got mud on your face. Big disgrace, somebody better put your bag into your place.
There's no question in my mind, if you say one of the top point guards to ever play this game, John Stockton's name is going to be there, because he is. I mean, he's proven it.
You watch players cut when Stockton has the ball. They have always got their hands up and their eyes on the ball, because you never know when he's going to let it go.
The guy plays both ends of the court. He is a very, very unselfish person, and he's a winner.
As an opposing player, as an opponent, I always hated playing against John Stockton. And I think, you know, that's a testament to the kind of player he was. He was a great player, and he always gave 110% every time he was out on the court.
I played against him, and he was like small guy, but he played with a lot of heart, and he was tough to play against. I didn't guard him, but when he made the screens on me, big screens, oh, he got hard elbows. He hit you hard. That's what I remember, you know. He changed my kidneys one time, like, that's... He played pretty tough.
What comes to mind when you mention John Stockton, the best point guard, best pure point guard to ever play the game of basketball?
Because he plays hard, he knows how to play the game, he does the little things that help a team win.
I think John's, over the years, has had the kind of respect that he's kind of set a standard for what the point guard position is all about and how it should be played.
I'm one of those guys that can honestly say it was an honor to play with John.
Just a tremendous work ethic. I really learned a lot about him and how he approached the game each and every day, not only during the games, but also in practice, and the way he just showed up every single time out there on the floor. And you knew you were gonna play John Stockton, you were gonna get his best.
And I always knew that you were such a great player, but it wasn't until I actually played with you on the court in the fourth quarter when I knew how good you really were.
He's one of these guys who just goes to show you when you have God-given ability, you put it to the maximum of use, you make the best of every situation, you work hard every day, you do what's right, the great things can happen.
I love his style, and I love the way he's dedicated himself to this game.
One of the greatest point guards to ever play the game, toughness, hard-working, a good guy, all-around good guy.
John, he's the greatest point guard all the time, you know, it's my opinion. You know, I love John, and I'm happy I have time to play with him. 2 years, it was great.
He was a pretty good player, you know. He was the best, you know.
John, this is Carlos Boozer talking to you. Happy retirement to you. You were a hell of a player. You know, it was a lot of fun watching you and Carl do your thing. Really proud of you for doing what you've been able to do for the NBA and obviously for Utah basketball. You guys were the cement and the foundation to this franchise. And we just want to thank you guys for what you've done, and good luck to you in your retirement.
He's one of the all-time greats. You know, when you talk about point guard, the classic point guard, it's John Stockton. There's a lot of different ways to play that position, but I think when people look at the old standard classic guy at that position. It's John Stockton.
You know, he really went out and competed against you every night.
It's amazing. I mean, he's got to be one of the toughest competitors in all of sports, you know, in the history of all sports.
Real quick story. One of the my second practice, I was already on crutches, being hurt my first year, and John Stockton says to Karl Malone, he goes, "I told you, you can never take a Geo into the mountains." And then Karl Malone says, "Yeah, they just don't build them like they used to, do they?" And so that was my introduction to the NBA by both those guys. And actually, John Stockton was an amazing player and also, you know, a real team leader.
John Stockton's passion for the game is incredible, and his leadership is even better.
My favorite Utah Jazz moment was I remember watching Stockton hit a three-point shot against Houston to send them to the finals, their first finals appearance.
Watching Stockton growing up, he was a great player, and I wish him the best.